Coming up on Crossfire Collectibles, the G.I. Joe Classified Series, number 102, Dreadnought Ripper. Stick around. What's up and welcome to Crossfire Collectibles. Happy Black Friday, and today's video will be unboxing and reviewing the G.I. Joe Classified Series number 102, Dreadnought Ripper. Hope everybody had a peaceful and hearty Thanksgiving. We didn't get nothing up yesterday, but I need a couple days of break. So I'm probably breaking in tomorrow, and we'll go ahead and jump to Buzzard on Sunday. But for now, let's go ahead and take care of Ripper, since he's the man of the hour. And we'll go over his box. So here you have Ripper. Got some motorcycles behind. There's a Cold Slither. Looks like grape soda cans on the ground. Or just purple cans of some type. Accessories up here. Artist rendition right there. Dreadnought Ripper. G.I. Joe at the top. You can see at the bottom. Flip to the side. 102 QR code if you want to check that out. Stats. Go to the back. Figure stands at 6.5 inches. Probably due to the mohawk. We gotta see how high it actually stands up on him though. There's his weapons. Close up of some tattoos. And close up of the glasses with his, looks like a razor blade earring. And flip to the side for a color shot of artist render. 102. And let's go ahead and get him open. So, but first, if you're new to the channel, be sure to like, share, and subscribe for future content. All right, break out that trusty dusty and slice him open. So I know a lot of people are picking up figures at Target, and a lot of people are getting turned away with street gates. So unfortunately, if it's that Target, then you're not likely going to get them there until you go back, you know, when they're supposed to actually go on sale, which I believe is December 1st. You got a couple others like Target with the Python Patrol stuff, and I believe that'll go on sale Monday on the 27th. So I would I'll clue you guys in kind of how I got mine a few times. I would just go on target.com at just after midnight to when the things have dropped. And go ahead and just put your order in for your closest store and have them sent right to you. Make sure that your store has that stuff. Type in the DPCI or TCIN number and do a search, and it should tell you what your stores have. Anyways, move on to Ripper. Here he is. It's crazy detailed. At the box. Back of it. His little green camo style wife beater thing doesn't really seem to be as, I guess, bright as the one on the box, but maybe it's just the lighting. Actually, let's go ahead and just pop him out so we can go over him in full detail. So, glad we're getting the rest of the Dreadnoughts in. It's still weird that we haven't gotten Torch. You figured maybe they'll bring them all out at once, or that you got two in this wave. So maybe the next wave they'll have I don't know, Xandar, we got Thrasher still coming, Road Pig, there's a bunch of them. Get this mess out of here. I'll show you the cardboard dungeon and the black and white render in the back. Good stuff. Alright, so let's go ahead and go over the figure. So first thing, I'm going to straighten some of this stuff up because he's got this necklace. It's all kind of jacked up. Well, if you go down and look at his little shoulder strap web gear right here. He's got a knife sheath, two grenades. He's got some spikes going over the little padded shoulder part. There's a peg coming off of the back. So I'm sure that's for his rifle. A peg for any type of backpack that he doesn't have, of course, to go in his back. Flip it around. So his necklace actually looks like there's three razor blades on there. And they're black. In light, they kind of look like they have a silver sheen to them, but no, they're definitely black. Going up to his head, the mohawk looks pretty good. A little long in the back, kind of like a mo mullet. or a hawk mullet, or whatever you want to call it. There's the razor blade earring in the right ear. Doesn't have one in the left ear. Try to get a better close-up shot of his face. And you can see he's got that teardrop right here under his left eye. Got some pretty cruddy looking teeth. Looks like his eyebrows have seen better days. You know, scratches and scars running all through it. And his right eye, I don't know if I can get that too close, but it's actually a smiley face. So he's got a fake eye. You might be able to see it from the box if we kind of zoom in. But if you look close in that eye, you can see a smiley face. Yeah, interesting. Anyways, you got the two-tone green, you know, tank top here. He's got, I think it's a Grim Reaper tattoo on his right shoulder. No more over here. On this side, you have, looks like some scratches coming down, some claws or rips. I'm not sure if that's supposed to be a bull or something. Maybe it's him with the horns because it has a mohawk. I don't know. Anyways, moving down, you have holster on his right thigh for a pistol. Chain coming off on the left side off his belt. The belt is not a separate piece. It's actually attached to this kind of hollow cod piece he has on that will be act as the top portion of his pants he has. Going all the way down, looks good. So check out the articulation. Head is on a ball joint, and it will do a full 360. Them spikes in that mohawk do not help. He can look up this far, and he can look down that far. The neck has a little bit of mobility. Going over to his shoulders, it's pretty stiff. It almost feels like the paint wasn't dry, but there's your butterfly joints at the shoulders. Put the arm out, arm can come out that far. And can do a full 360. Here's bicep swivel. He's got this golden spiked strap around his bicep on the right side. Let's try to crack those, but he's got double jointed pinless elbows. Come down to the hand, right under that, he's got this spiked gauntlet or bracelet. He's got a hinged peg hand. It can rotate a full 360, and go down that far, and it can go up that far. All right, so he's got ab crunch, so that far forward, and that far back. He's got waist swivel, the holster out, drop legs, which don't seem like much at all, but they are there. Thigh rotation. Legs can go out to the side that far, forward that far, and back not far. There's also double jointed pinless knees. Come up. So he's got some knee pads on. He's got some all black boots with a shin guard on most of the boot, you know, covering them laces. There's a swivel at the top of the boot and right at the middle of the shin. Let me see, there's hinge in his boots to go forward that far, up that far, and side to side pivot. So all right, there's your articulation on Ripper. Go ahead and stand him back some. Might have to crack that knee just to he's a little off balance. Drop test, good. All right, we'll be going to the accessory box. Cobra, 102, Dreadnought Ripper, 102. Put this open, box to the side. Crap. Got your G.I. Joe Cobra baggie here. Accessories. Something else in there. Guess not. Alright, now he's got all kinds of stuff in here, so let's go ahead and go over it. Pull that trusty dusty back out and slice that tape. And go over this first. So, he's got his sort of traditional rifle here. You know, he's got the blade coming off the front like his other ones did. It's pretty cool. Looks good. I like it. So nice. Got a scope on it. It's like a dark gray, I guess. The blade has a like a silver metallic light painting over it, but there is some black areas up at the tip and the edges, so not the best of paint jobs. He does have a hole at the end of the barrel for a blast effect. There is a slot here for a magazine, and we'll go ahead and grab that. So here it is right here, just a smaller magazine, maybe 6 capacity. Go ahead and plug that in. There we go. It looks nice. All right, next, move on to his knife. And as you can see, it's kind of got like the survival style blade on it, serrated top, razor bottom, black handle, black knuckle guards. So he could use this one or the other to, you know, knife fight, you know, digging his blade in the ground. So we're just getting into a fist fight and using that as a weapon. Bop, bop, bop. It's pretty cool. All right, moving on to his pistol here, which is really weird looking. I'm not sure what kind of pistol this is. Looks like maybe it was a tweak revolver, or they took some kind of old German gun and threw it on something. I don't know what that is. That's just odd. But it does have a blade put onto the front, which is weird. Just looks like they turned the blade, flipped it upside down. So you have the serration at the bottom here, and it looks like the blade will be at the top. It could be a single shot, because it looks like that was the barrel itself would come down. You might load a bullet, pop it back up, and that's that. I don't really like this too much. It's like a little too, you know, piratey for me, but it is what it is. That'll be going in his sheath. Next up, his glasses. So you got the all gray frame with the sort of metallic red lenses on them. And not much about them until we actually get them on them. But here they are. They look pretty good. And then finally, moving on, we have the jaws of life. So I was wondering how they would do this, but at least it's not just a separate piece and falls off like the modern ones. God, that annoyed the hell out of me. But yeah, it looks like you have an exhaust port back here. This would be the motor down here. So got a tube running up into, I guess, feed this. Here's the handle, probably trigger at the top, the front guard so he can hold onto it so it doesn't go crazy on him. And here are the jaws up in the front. Okay, so they can move, you know, simultaneously when you do that. It's probably got a nice little gear in there or something that it works with. That's pretty cool. But yeah, so here that is. See them like 3 different colors. You have gray, dark gray, and like a gunmetal. But yeah, so cool, man. That looks pretty neat. I was kind of wondering how they were going to do that, but so since he doesn't have a backpack, it's obvious that this rifle is going to go ahead and plug on the backpack here. So maybe it's kind of at an angle, so it looks like it's not going to go straight on, so it'll be at a side, you know, positioning like that. Get this arm lifted up some. We're going to go ahead and get rid of this goofy pistol and put that to his sheath right here. Take that knife. We'll come over to sheath on his chest and slide that on up in there, and that fits really well, so that's nice. Take his glasses and put them on his head. They don't fit that great. I mean, they're over his ears, but they look a little odd, but there they are. And then let's go ahead and figure out how we're gonna do these jaws of life here. So I'll kind of just do like the box art. Bend that hand some. Get the handle up through there. Where he's got a grip on it. pretty much it. Let's see, break that one down a little bit more. I have some decent positioning. It just seems like it's holding a little too low. And this one should be straight. And that's get them fingers around that front part. Let's back in. Let's see what kind of pose we're gonna get him in. I wanna do kind of like a, almost like he has to position himself really well to use this, but he's not gonna stand like that, or maybe he will. However, I do have a couple of these stands here. So I'll tell you about them. I got them on Amazon. They're from Figures Lab. So it's like 30 bucks or something like that, but you get 100 of these. So two per figure. They can fit right into the bottom of the figure's feet, and these fit G.I. Joe's, or G.I. Joe Classifieds anyway, perfectly. So give that a nice twist and spin to get in there. And then move on to the next one. They're a little tough to get in because they are a little thick, but that's good because you don't want them sliding out if you have them on your figure and the figure is in some awkward position. But see, I try to get this leg up or something like this. I want them kind of low, but not too low. Just a good position. I think it would work. So with all that, that's the pose we got him in. I think he looks all right. So let's go ahead and get him thrown up on the turntable and I'll give you some final thoughts.
G.I. Joe will return after these messages.
Be sure to check out our previous videos. A link will always be pinned in the comments.
Now back to G.I. Joe.
All right, so here is your G.I. Joe Classified Series, number 102, Dreadnought Ripper. He's pretty cool. He has a lot of, you know, unique features. I'm noticing that, you know, as he's going around. It's cool. It, you know, brings out the nostalgia of the Dreadnought figures themselves, especially with some of that, you know, them worn out gear and, you know, that barbarianish style that he has. Yeah, with them crazy mohawk, you know, tattoos all over him, the biker gear. He's cool. I did have the original Ripper back in the 80s, you know, with Real American Hero. And he was one of the first figures I got from G.I. Joe. I definitely had to pick him out. I just thought he was neat. I had no idea what that weapon was, but, you know, obviously it's the Jaws of Life. It's too bad that this figure doesn't come with a backpack. Like, I'll show you the modern backpack right here. That would be neat if this one had it. So that way, if you didn't want to store the rifle, you can store the Jaws of Life, and that would be cool to have him hold a rifle or something. But anyways, overall, I think he's a decent figure. It probably could have used a little more work. I think he almost was kind of rushed. Like, they threw something on him. Oh, let's keep it. He's a Dreadnought. Let's keep him. He's a Dreadnought. Why no backpack again? What's up with this wave in the backpacks? But anyways, that's going to do it for this one. I hope you guys enjoyed what you saw. If you did, please, like always, leave that giant thumbs up. Subscribe. Tickle that bell so you're notified when we post future videos. Be sure to follow us on social media, and we'll see you Sunday with Buzzer. Peace.